Dear students, welcome to NRS YouTube channel. So in the previous class we discussed regarding how to insert table in the Microsoft Word document. So regarding the table, that how to insert, which tab we have to use, and to insert the table what are the different kinds of ways we have. So that we discussed, that is in insert tab, right? So we have to use insert tab, and in the insert tab we have three options. One is with the help of grid you can insert the table, or you can use insert option, and you can use draw table option, so to insert the table in the document. So, and also we discussed the different, you know, the properties of the table in the last class. So today, dear students, we'll discuss about how to protect our document and how to print the document, right? And how we'll go for find and replace, right? So first of all, I will go for protect the document. So protecting the document, or applying the protection, or applying password for the document, right? So why we should protect the document, isn't it? So the protection of the document is also a very important, right? Suppose you have created a document with some confidential material you have added in the document, right? Suppose in your home you have your computer system, and in that computer system you have created one Microsoft Word document, and in that document you have added some confidential material or data information in it. So to, in order to protect such kind of, you know, document from the third person, it may be your, you know, so suppose I will tell you one thing. Suppose we are using computers in our school. So suppose the school computers, they are well protected, you know, that it's only access for the students, and we have some special computers we have, so only the admin can use those computers, right? So that in a computer which you are using in your home, so the computer in home, so everybody can access your computer, right? So for like your brothers, sisters, your parents, or your friends, or your neighbors, your you know, relatives. So whenever they will come to visit your home, they are very easy, and they can access your computer easily, right? So to, in order to protect the document which it has very confidential in data information, so you need to protect them. So how to protect? Just look at the screen, all of you. So now here I will go for I will type something, right? Right, okay. So on the international school, what I have typed. So you can just imagine this is my confidential, you know, information I have added. So now I will save this file. So the file name I will give you NIRS. So, and then you can save the file. So I will save in desktop. I will select. Okay. So here I will save. Then click on save button. Okay, so the my file name is NIRS, right? So now I will close this one and I will go for NIRS. So here I have my file, NIRS file I have. So if you double click over here, easily you can get the data information. So now I need to protect this document, right? So to protect this document, you need to click on the file tab, right? And then go for here we have option called info. Okay, so click on info. So already it is there. So now here we have a protect document. Okay, so click on protect document, and here you have option called encrypt with password. Encrypt with password. Click on encrypt with password. So here you need to give a password, right? So here one important note he has given, caution, that is if you lose, you forget the password, it cannot be recovered. It is advisable to keep a list of passwords and their corresponding document names in a safe place. Remember that password are case sensitive. So it means, suppose if you forgot the password of that particular document, so you cannot recover it. So that, so it's better to after applying the password, you need to write it in a personal notebook or a book. So it means whenever you forget the password, you are able to, you know, access that password easily, right? So, and it is a case sensitive. So now I will give the password as 123 I have given. Then click on OK. So again, re-enter the password, the same password you need to enter, 123, Okay, you're gonna click on OK. Okay, so now again you can save this file. Now close it. So here I have a file, right? So now I will open this file. Yes, so what it is asking, password, enter the password to open the file, right? So the password is 123, you click on OK. Yes, so this is how you can protect your document from the unknown person or a third person, right? So this is what we have, a password protection. Okay, so next we'll move on to the printing the document. So how to print the document? Okay, so after completing your document work, so whether it is the editing work, whether it is you know, that adding or removing something in the text or applying the formatting design for the text, suppose if you completed everything of your document, then the last option is you need to print that report. You have to print the document. So how to print the document? It's very simple. Just you can click on file tab and then click on print option. Okay, so here we have a print option. Click on print, and then here we have so many options like selecting the printer and the number of pages. So how many pages you need to print, that you have to provide, and so many here. The if you want to change the page size, you can change the page size here. So right now it is letter size is there. If you want a legal size, you can change it. And at last, number of copies, how many copies you need, that you can enter here. And at last, we have a print option. If you click over print, you will get the printout, right? So the shortcut keys for the print is Control P. Okay, so if you press Control P, you will get the same interface, that is print interface you will get. So this is how you can take the printout. Okay, so next one we'll move on to the one more very important concept in Microsoft Word, that is find and replace. So what is find and what is replace? So as the name itself says, that find in the sense, suppose you have a document with that more pages, like 20 pages, 500 pages, 100 pages, 50 pages. So in such kind of document, suppose you need to find a word or a text or anything, so you have to use but manually it is very difficult to find out the some particular word. Suppose in a document, suppose you have entered a NIRS, so you need to check or you need to find out that particular text in the document. So by manually it takes too much of time, right? So that we have a option called find. So the shortcut key for find is, that is Control F. Or here you have an option called in editing group. Look at the screen. In editing group, here we have a find. So if you click on find, so at the left side of the document, you will get a navigation pane. In the navigation, you have option that is find. So now I will enter. I want to find a word that is school. Right. So if you click OK, then enter. So it will be that particular word will be highlighted in the document. So what you have entered here, so this is what the text I need to find out in my document. So if you enter here, then automatically it will be highlighted, right? So next one more we have, that is find is over. Next is replace. So replace means suppose instead of here the school, International Residential School is there, right? So instead of school, I need to enter the college, right? So wherever in my document, wherever I have a school, I need what, college, right? So you, in order to make it replace, you need to click on replace option. So here you will get, so next here the find what. Okay, find what, school, replace with. So in the find what text box, you have to enter school, which text you need to find, and what you want to replace, sorry, from which text you want to replace, that is you have to enter here. So I will go for college. So it means wherever the school text we have, it replaced with the college, right? So we'll go for it. Next, here we have option called replace, replace all, and find next. So you need to go for one by one, then you can go for find next, and then you can go for replace. Or if you want to, no need to find the school text, then you can directly click on replace. Or if you want to, no need to check, just you can replace the school text from the college, then you can click on replace all. So now we'll go for replace. click over here, click on replace, right? Board has finished searching the document because we have only one text, that is school, right? So this is called replace. So you may ask the question that, sir, we have only one text, that is a school, why we should go for the replace? Just you can erase it and type college, right? So what initially I told you, suppose if you have a document with 50 pages, 100 pages and 1000 pages, then how it is possible to erase the text and retype it, right? So in order to do that particular work easier, we have a find and replace option, right? So dear students, in the next class we'll see how to apply the page number and how to save the document. So after that we'll go for spreadsheet. Okay, thank you.